Okay, now we'll discuss about break, continue, and pass. So, break, continue, and pass. These three, we will call it as a control statement. So, break, continue, pass. These three, we call it as a control statements. When it comes to break, so break is already, we are familiar with C programming, C, Java. So in C and Java, we are having break statement. Similar, the same functionality here also we are having. So the break statements are used in looping statements. So if you want to break the looping process, at that time we can go with just break. So if you mention the break, then automatically the controller will come out from the looping statement. So that is the advantage of break. Assume it, I'm having one loop which is possible to print the numbers from 1 to 10, but I want to exit at the time of getting the number 5. Once I reached 5, I want to come out from the loop. Means I don't want to print the remaining numbers. Then simply we can mention the break statement. If you apply the break statement, then automatically it will terminate the loop and it will come out. So, and one more thing is, if you are applying the break in inner loop, means if you are having nested loops, if the program is having nested loops, if you apply the break in inner loop, then that inner loop only will terminate and again the outer loop will execute. So we'll go through an example of these things. So we are using break and these all things, just to make. And similarly, we are having another statement called continue. So this continue statement also used in looping statements itself. But the difference between break and continue is the break statement will terminate the loop. The controller will come out from the loop. But continue is not like that. So continue, what it is doing is it will continue the next iteration. Assume it, I'm having some 5 statements under a loop and I want to execute these 5 statements 10 times. Then I will apply one looping statement which executes these 5 statements 10 times. So when I applied continue, after first statement, so it will execute only the first statement only. And again, it will repeat the second iteration. Again, it will execute first statement only. Means the remaining 4 statements will be omitted. So if you want to apply based on the condition, we can apply with condition also. If you don't want condition, then we can leave it. So this is about continue. So we'll check an examples of both. and third one is pass. So generally there is a situation is there. So if you are having any looping statements and you are supposed to write the looping statements without any statements, means just looping statement is there and I don't have any statements to write under that loop. Maybe in future I'm going to write, but right now I want to conclude my program. In that situation, you can use pass, means without any statement. It's a null statement. Simply we say that it is a null statement. So we'll go on an example of these three things. So first we'll discuss about break. So assume it some data, some program which I want to display only odd numbers. So and I'm having one list which contains some data. It contains some data, but my program, my information is I want to display only odd numbers. If I received any even number, then I don't want to continue the list and I want to come out from that one. Means here, when I assume that I received the first element is 1, it is odd 1, will display it. Second element is 3, it is odd 1, will display it. Third element is 5, it is odd 1, will display it. Fourth element is 7, it is odd 1, will display it. And next I received 8, it is even. So when I received any event, just I want to terminate that one. I don't want to consider the remaining elements, just I want to come out from that one. So this is the program, we'll check it, how it is going to execute. So I need to read the elements from the list. With the help of for loop, I can read some for v in list one, colon. So it is getting indentation. So now what I'm doing, I need to print the elements of odd numbers. Once I received any event, just I want to conclude that one and I want to come out from that one. So if v percentage 2 equal to 0, simply I am applying break and just I am coming out, just I am printing print of v. When you check it, it is getting 1357. When I read 8, so it is even number, just it is coming out. So different situations are there. Based on the situation, we can use break statement. Here my situation is I want to list out only odd numbers, but at any case, if I received even number, then I want to come out from that list and I don't want to consider remaining, either it may having even or odd, I don't want to consider, just I want to come out. That is my situation. So in that situation, I can use break. So this is about the break statement. So it will be used in loops to terminate the loop, to come out from the loop. And second one is continue is there. So we'll check one example on continue. So continue, it is using, it continues the iteration, means whatever the remaining statements are there, it will omit and it will continue that one. So for example, so just I want to display even numbers only and I don't want to go with odd numbers. So similarly, I'm taking some list one, some equal to some values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what I'm doing is for v in list one. So if the statement is, if the value is odd number, and I'm not supposed to print that one. So what I'm doing is, if v percentage two is not equal to zero, then just I'm going continue. Otherwise, print of v means, if I'm getting odd number, then I don't want to take the print statement. So I want to save the time. So if I'm having odd number, I don't want to go for print statement. Just it will continue the loop. So once if we execute it, we'll take 2, 4, 6, 8. So how it is going to execute is for v in list 1 means it will take 1 value. So first I'm having value 1, so it will take the value 1, and then after it checks, is it not divisible by 2? Yes, 1 is not divisible by 2, then continue. So means it will continue the loop. And actually print statement is also comes under loop only. But without executing this statement, the loop will continue. Again, it will read the second statement, second value, that is 2. So if 2%, is it not equal to 0? No, it is equal to 0. Then continue statement will not execute directly. It comes to print. So print V means it is displaying value 2. So again, next value 3, I am checking. So like that, if the condition is, this condition is satisfied, continue will execute. Means the intention of continue is I want to eliminate the below statements and I want to go for next iteration. That is the, if you are having that intention, then go with continue. So in practical situations, these break continue will play the main role. And third one is pass. So pass maximum will use if you are having any if statements or looping statements. Under that, if you don't have any statements, I'm having looping, but I don't have any statement to write on that one. In that situation, we can go with pass. So if I don't want to write anything, then it will raise error. For example, I am considering some I equal to 1. So while I less than or equal to 10. And I don't have any statement to execute here. Just I will keep as it is there. So unexpected end of while parsing, I am getting this type of error. Even though if I press enter also, so I am getting same error. Then what we supposed to do? So if I don't have any statements to run under loop, in future I may get, but right now I don't have any statement to write. Then simply I go with pass. If I mention pass, then it will not get any error. So hope you understood the concept. So if I am writing one particular program under loop or as under if statement, you supposed to write some statements under looping or under if statement, you supposed to write some statements. But right now I don't know, and I may get it in future. After 2 days or after 3 days, after solving some particular problem, there you can get the solution and I will keep here. In that situation, so go with pass. Pass is nothing but null statement, empty statement. We can say that it is a empty statement. So these three are the control statements in Python. So if someone called, what are the control statements? We can go with break, continue, pass. Next important concept is functions.